Rise and shine, every pony. Breakfast is waiting.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, every pony.
I'll rise, but I refuse to shine.
Is this an apple?
It's an apple mana.
Well, at least these ones don't have faces.
Or legs.
Or little frightened screams.
Oh, I do hope my accommodations were up to snuff. You did all sleep comfortably, correct?
I wouldn't exactly call that comfortable.
Why, whatever do you mean, Rainbow Dash?
You know exactly what I mean, Discord. It's kind of hard to sleep in a room swarming with fish that swim around in the air breathing out bubbles of water.
You think that was bad? My room was a hologram. Everything was fake, except perhaps the bed. I must have been searching around for it for nearly half an hour before I found it in the middle of the dresser. I didn't dare look for a bathroom. And do you know how hard it was to find a door out of there this morning?
My bed was alive. It was like a cute little kitty. Oh, yes, it was. It even purred.
My whole room was a bed. It was like one of those padded rooms at the hospital, except it was too soft. I kept falling into the floor.
Well, if we're comparing notes, I guess my room didn't seem so bad. The whole thing was darn near edible, except the smells were all wrong. The chocolate bedpost smelled like oranges, the flower petal blanket smelled like blueberry pie, and the cotton candy pillow smelled like daisies.
Aw, Lucky! Did you save some for me?
I didn't eat any of it, Pinkie Pie.
Quick, Discord, show me where Applejack slept!
What about you, Fluttershy? What was your room like?
Well, my room was kind of normal. It was decorated to look like a summer meadow. Oh, and there were cute little animals painted on the walls. It was kind of sweet.
Oh, sure. You get the special treatment.
Well, this is the thanks that I get for opening up my home to you ponies. And here I thought we were friends.
Of course we're your friends, and I'm sure every pony is grateful. We've just never stayed anywhere quite like this before. Right, girls?
Yeah!
Totally!
All right, every pony, let's get back to the task at hoof. Every minute we waste here is another minute Twilight is stuck in that dungeon cell.
Spike and I can go practice flying on the southern hills just outside Canterlot. There's some awesome cliffs that we can use.
Cliffs?
Don't you worry, Spikey Wikey. I'll go with you. I won't let Rainbow hurt a single hair on your mane. Besides, I'd rather not get dirt and dust in my mane from that delightful rodeo.
And I'm going with Applejack and Fluttershy. Maybe if I'm lucky, I can get some caramel corn and peanuts and cotton candy. Applejack, are you sure they won't let you in? Maybe if we just explain to them our situation, they might.
I'm sorry, Sugar Cube. Those rodeo officials are mighty picky about their contestants. I've been in every event up until now. I don't think they'll allow us standing at this point. But don't you worry. I've got a couple of ideas that might get us out of this mess.
Are we sure it's a good idea to split up? That didn't work out so well for us the last time.
I know it's not the best idea, Sugar Cube, but if we don't split up now, we may not get tickets.
Should we just figure out a time and place to meet afterwards?
How about the concession stand at the rodeo?
Pinkie, how are you still hungry?
Oh, I'm never too full for caramel corn, or candy corn, or regular corn with butter.
How about we just agree to meet at the rodeo arena instead? So long as Spike learns how to fly quickly enough, we can get Spitfire and the Wonderbolts here before it's over.
Isn't any pony going to invite me? How rude.
Oh, Discord, would you like to come with us to...
Oh, I'd love to, my dear Fluttershy, but I'm afraid I have plans of my own and won't have even a moment to spare.
Then what in the hoof are you going on about?
Well, it's always nice to be asked.
Look who we are and what we have been through. Being a princess is also brand new. Can't wait to see what our future has in store.
Don't wanna wait anymore. Too boredom, we say goodbye.
We have limits that we should defy. Possibilities endless to sky.
It's not difficult to show we care.
We've got plenty of kindness to share.
And we know that nothing could compare. So here we go. It's time, let the adventure begin. Oh, 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 friendship through thick and thin. Oh, 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 let the adventure begin. Oh, 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 so here we go. Let the adventure begin. Friendship through thick and thin. Let the adventure begin.
Awesome! All right, Spike, just flap a little faster. No, wait, slow down. No, don't tilt like that. You'll just...
I stayed up longer this time.
I guess so, but you're not going to be getting anywhere flying like that.
Oh, you are doing just fine. I'm sure you'll get the hang of it any moment now.
I just need to get a little more speed going before I take off.
Ugh! He'll never learn to fly in time!
Of course he will. He just needs a little more encouragement is all. You're doing so well, Spike. Look at all the progress you've made.
Thanks, Rarity. But you don't have to lie to me. I know how much is at stake. I mean, what if Applejack doesn't win the rodeo and No Pony gets a ticket into the gala, and Twilight has to stay in the Canterlot dungeon even longer because I can't get to Cloudsdale to find Spitfire? Because I can't fly! I'm sorry you got stuck switch with me, Rainbow Dash. I wish you could have at least traded with Fluttershy. Or any other dragon, for that matter. You know, one with wings.
Now, what kind of attitude is that? I'm glad you're the one who gets to fly up there and save the day. You want to know why? Because you're the most determined little pony, or dragon, that I've ever met. Listen to me, Spike. I'll teach you how to fly. You've just got to be fast, then you'll be in the sky. And so...
Now hold on, Rainbow Dash, it's not just about speed. Elegance and grace are what you really need for fleeting, flying, gliding.
Elegance and grace, are you joking me? He'll learn from the best, and that of course is me. Cause I'm the best flyer there will ever be. Don't go acting like it's you. He'll be airborne. You just wait and see. There's nothing you can do.
I had wings before, do you not recall? And I flew with poison style. If you taught him, all he'd do is fall. He could learn that from me by a mile.
Oh! Heck no! Do I hear a challenge?
It seems so. I have far more talent.
So tell me what you learned when you flew up towards the sun. Falling to your doom, was it really fun? I saved you, it's true. Don't need you.
Oh, you're the one to talk after what we've seen you do. Isn't Rainbow Crash what they used to call you? You're reckless, regardless, so careless.
It's a skill.
No, it's an art.
Can't be felt, it must be taught.
It's the only way he'll ever reach the sky.
Cause I'm the best flyer there will ever be. Don't go acting like it.
myself, I had wings before. And I flew faster than you. I could teach him all he needs and more. Looks like your time teaching him is through.
Oh! Heck no, you just keep on dreaming.
It is you I shall be creaming.
Things are looking down. I'm still on the ground.
He'll be soaring high.
Yeah, right.
It will happen.
It won't happen.
Yeah!
No.
You guys, you're wasting our precious time. All the wild twilight in jail for tickets, my fly must be prime. Otherwise, we will fail.
It seems Spikey has got a point. We must learn to get along.
I guess you're right now, we must be joined. Rather than waste time singing this stupid song. So, let's go.
I can do it.
See, Spike? You've got all the right stuff. Now come on. Twilight's not going to sit in that cell if we have anything to say about it.
Oh, yeah.
So get out there and show me some flapping.
Okay.
What?
I just don't know how you did it. Cheer up, Spike, like that. I've been trying all morning to give him some encouragement. Usually he's always so pleasant around me.
Maybe he can't take you seriously when you look like that.
What? Not serious. Are you kidding me? Pinkie Pie or not, I am still the best motivator to my little spiky-wiky, and I am going to prove it!
Oh, hey, Rarity. I know. I'm doing so well, and I'll get it soon.
Now you listen here, Spike. You're going to get up there, and you're going to maintain your altitude, and you will land on the ground with grace. Do you hear me? It's just like I said before. Flying is not just about speed. It's like a dance. There are so many different factors you have to take into consideration. Use the breeze to lift up your wings and allow it to carry your whole body. Flap your wings in unison. Make them work together to lift you up off the ground.
Hey, look! I'm doing it! Thanks, Rarity!
Anytime.
That's exactly what I've been trying to teach him all morning! How did you know all that?
Surely you remember my famous debut in Cloudsdale with my beautiful... beautiful wings. Well, I wasn't going to say anything, but even a graceful pony like myself needed to take a few flying attempts before she got the hang of it. Honestly, I don't see what all the fuss is about.
Rainbow! Rarity! Look at me!
That's great, Spike. Now it's time to put it to the real test. Let's head on over to those cliffs.
The cliffs?
I hope Age is having better luck than we are.
Agreed.
Name, please.
Applejack. And these are my...
coaches.
Both of them?
Yes.
Fluttershy here handles all the stunt practices, and I'm her manager. Now, did you remember to get the sparkling cider for my client's dressing room?
There are no dressing rooms here. This is a rodeo, not a fashion show.
What? You will be hearing from our lawyers! We were promised cider!
Come on, Rarity. Let's leave the nice official alone now.
I'll have my ponies contact your ponies, you hear me?
Let's go.
Cider.
What in the hay was all that?
I don't know. Isn't that what manager ponies do? I mean, they make unreasonable demands and scream a lot.
All right, look.
We're supposed to warm up over there with the other contested ponies. Be careful. Not all of them are friendly.
Oh, dear.
That one there is Red Spur. He's the champion from Vancouver. Lavender Fritter from Appaloosa. Ginger Gold from Baltimore. But watch out for... Belle Star. She's a nasty one. Don't want to get caught up in her path.
Applejack, I don't think I can do this.
Nonsense. We've just got to stick to the plan, remember?
Right, so... I have to lasso that bale of hay and drag it over the line there, and then fall into the mud pit at the second challenge?
Exactly. It's the same trick Rarity and I pulled at Sisterhood Social. I'll swap places with you till we reach the finish line, and then you can jump in and claim the prize.
Easy peasy, lemon squeezy.
Why don't we give lassoing a try?
Okay.
You gotta really use those leg muscles, Sugar Cube. Try aiming for that there fence post.
Good job, Fluttershy! You just caught an Applejack!
Oh, I'm sorry.
Don't be sorry. That was great. Just gotta work on your aim a bit is all.
What's the matter, Applejack? Nerves finally getting to you, huh? I seem better last wing from kindergarten fillies. Guess you're not really cut out for the big leagues, are ya? Maybe you're afraid you'll lose to a non-farm pony. That'd be embarrassing.
I would never... She would never be afraid of the likes of you.
Whatever. I'll see you at the finish line as long as I'm not too bored from waiting.
Oh, you'll see her all right. You'll see her accept the trophy.
Applejack?
Why, that no good side-winded salamander.
Applejack, what if she's right? Maybe I can't learn to lasso this in time.
You've got plenty of time, Fluttershy. A whole 10 minutes to practice.
10 minutes?
Contestants to the starting lines.
Oh, strike that. I guess my watch is a bit slow.
Calm down, Sugar Cube. You'll be just fine. All you have to worry about is reaching that mud pit, okay?
Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Oh, dear.
Come on, Fluttershy. Let's get you to the starting line.
I don't think this is such a great idea. All those ponies watching me, judging me. Maybe we should just help Spike get to Cloudsdale.
Aw, it's not that bad. I have to perform in front of ponies all the time. Nothing terrible's ever happened to me before.
Really?
Sure. Unless you count the time that I slipped and fell into the table and had the punch bowl land on my face. Or maybe the time I accidentally tripped over that tree root and I knocked over Mayor Mare just before she was about to take that first yummy bite of cake at the Ponyville Day celebration.
Contested ponies at the ready. On your mark.
You can do it, Fluttershy.
Get set.
No, I can't. I'll ruin everything.
I know you can. Besides, you're the best. Oh, hey, look. I found the cotton candy pony.
The best what? Pinkie!
Go, Fluttershy!
Hello! Okay, Fluttershy. Show them what you've got.
Nice lassoing, farm pony.
Hey, I did it.
Great job, partner. I'll take it from here.
Jack has a lot of catching up to do.
This is it, folks. The last stretch of this year's Equestria Rodeo Days Championship. The contestant ponies are making their way to the bull maze now, with Red Spur in the lead, followed by Golden Harvest and Applejack. For those of you unfamiliar with this final event, each pony will have to wear a brightly colored vest and guide one of Equestria's finest bulls through the hay maze to the finish line. The pony whose bull crosses the line first is the winner. Now, these vests are brightly colored for a reason. Each of these bulls has been trained to follow a certain color, each of them different, so that each contestant pony is responsible for one bull and one bull alone. It's any pony's game now.
Come on, Applejack. You can do this. Twilight's counting on you. Yeehaw! Get along, you big critter.
I will not be beaten by that farm pony. I think I need a shortcut. Come on, you big stupid animal. Follow me.
I would have been if it weren't for Spitfire here.
Looks like we came just in time.
Are the other contestants
safe? Thanks to you.
I was just doing what I had to do.
All right, Wonderbolt, let's round up some cats.
You're the only pony who came even close to the finish line. Does that mean you win?
I don't think so, Spike. They know we cheated.
Aw, come on. You should get extra points for saving lives.
Matter anyway. The Wonderbolts are here. We don't need those tickets. Spitfire will get us in.
Yeah, about that. I think we should go have a little talk somewhere a bit less rowdy.
But I don't understand. You're the Wonderbolts. What do you mean you can't get us in?
I'm afraid it's not like that, Rainbow Dash. We don't use tickets to get into the gala. We just join in after our performance.
And boy, are we hungry by then. But maybe there's something we can do to help. You know, if you can figure out how to get inside.
We'll be more than happy to help you get past that phony princess. If what Spike tells us is true, it sounds to me like Trixie's the kind of pony who likes a lot of attention. We sure get plenty of that.
Well, it's better than nothing, I guess.
I'm sorry to hear this happen to you all.
Imagine our surprise when Spike here shows up looking like you, Rainbow.
And just in the nick of time, too.
We've gotta go. Our show starts soon. Come find us once you're inside.
Yeah, I'm sorry we can't be more helpful.
We'll figure it out.
Oh, I can't believe how much fun it is to watch you ponies in a crisis. Priceless.
Wait, what? Are you telling me you've been watching us all along?
I thought you had more important things to do today than help us.
No, well, you see, that's a funny story. The more I thought about it, the more I felt left out. I didn't want to miss out on your next big adventure. You've been putting on quite the performance, my little ponies. I'd have to say my favorite part so far has been the flying lesson you gave our little dragon friend.
You watched that and you didn't even offer to go to Cloudsdale for us?
Oh, you were getting along just fine without me. Quite a catchy tune, too. 'cause I'm the best flyer there will ever be. Fabulous. So fabulous, in fact, that I think it's inspired me to write a little something of my own. Ahem. Me. You ponies seem to think that the Reform Discord has lost his sense of chaos. Could this possibly be true? No. Positively no. The Spanish for no. No. Perish the thought. So why the long faces? Have I left your good graces? I think it's about time someone taught you ponies a thing or two about having fun. And as particularly handsome as and by far the most clever once said, making sense, where's the fun? Don't you know that is so overdone? Don't you see what fun can be had when the whole world's going mad? What's the point of a trial if the task doesn't bring you a smile? Now I could study spellbooks for a boring old cure, or maybe fight a fool's like a matador. Perhaps that might be of some use, but seems such a bore. Where's the fun? Where's the fun? Paper dash, where's the fun? If the plot ends before it's begun. If I had run that errand for you, Spike here would never have flew. Try Havoc, Mayhem too. Have a ball, after all, that's what I do. I start off introducing just a problem or two, then watch your crazy ponies try to muddle on through. It's rather entertaining just to see what you'll do. That's what's fun, always fun. Come now, my little ponies, sing along, why don't you? After all, it's fun. Where's the fun? Where's the fun? All is well, so there was no harm done. I couldn't very well just let this pat me on by, 'cause watching you all make me laugh so hard I could cry. You see, I just can't help myself around you. Oh, where's the fun? Where's the fun? Where's the fun? You're all so hopeless. Thank you. You're all much too kind. Thank you.
What do we do now?
Maybe we could just sneak in?
That's a mite too risky.
Every garden canterlot will be there.
Well, though I'm loath to admit it, I find the most efficient way to get oneself into a party is with an invitation. Well, no pony ever thought to ask me if I had a way into the gala.
Why? But when? How?
Princess Celestia gave them to me. She told me to invite you ponies while she was gone. She said you six might keep things interesting. She was certainly right about that. If you don't want my tickets, then I can just invite some pony else.
Don't you even think about it.
My. If looks could kill, I'd be a goner. Oh, come now. Has every pony lost their sense of humor?
Discord, I think you need to go.
I beg your pardon?
I said, I think you need to go.
Oh, I get it. Every pony is mad at me. Boo-hoo. Does every pony really feel this way? Would you really turn away a friend who has saved you in this hour of need?
Don't you lecture me, mister. You've hurt your friend's feelings, and you need to give us some space until you can say you're sorry.
Sorry? What about you, Pinkie Pie? Surely you can take a good joke? All right, everypony. I can take a hint. maybe I'll just give you all a little time to appreciate my humor. When you're ready to be friends again, you know where to find me.
Remind me again why we continue to associate with that creature.
I have no idea, Rarity. No idea.
I want 4 guards posted at every door. Do you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
This gala cannot... will not be ruined by those meddlesome ponies. I refuse to let my night fall to ruin because of your incompetence. I mean, really, how hard is it to capture a little dragon and a pony?
We're sorry, ma'am. We're still looking for them.
Don't bother. They've no doubt joined up with their little friends by now. All I care about is keeping them out. Every guest must have a ticket, no exceptions. And if you find them, I want them brought to me immediately. Is that understood?
Could you describe them, ma'am?
Oh, I don't know. One of them has a rainbow in her mane. One of them's pink. I think one of them's a unicorn. Ugh, I can't be expected to remember all that. Just look for the little dragon. They'll be with him.
Yes, ma'am.
Ugh, I'm surrounded by idiots. Oh, Princess Luna. I didn't see you there. Is something the matter, Twilight Sparkle? What? Oh no, everything's fine. What makes you say that? Weren't those your friends you were just describing? My friends? No, no, no. These are completely different ponies. My friends are... well, they're super busy. These other ponies were the ones that were trying to harbor Trixie. And I'm sure they're going to want to try and sneak into the gala to break her out. That is a rather large coincidence, don't you think? Coincidence? 5 ponies and a dragon. I assure you, Princess, I know exactly what we're up against. Trust me, these ponies are not ones to be trifled with. If you'll excuse me, I have decorations for the gala to oversee. Something is not right.